Hi, in this video, we are going to talk about acute pancreatitis. My name is Dr. Richard Menezes. I'm a general and laparoscopic surgeon based in Mumbai, and I teach general surgery to medical college students at Sion Hospital in Mumbai. So let's begin. What is pancreatitis? Pancreatitis is a sudden onset, swelling or irritation of the pancreas. The pancreas is an organ within your belly, and this organ secretes hormones and digestive juices that helps in the digestion of your food. The most important hormone secreted by the pancreas is insulin.
What causes pancreatitis?
Now, pancreatitis happens or occurs due to two reasons. Number one is gallstone disease. Now, I have made a video on gallstone disease in which the absolute basics needed for patients of this disease are explained. Gallstone disease causes pancreatitis when a gallstone produced in the gallbladder slips into the bile duct and gets stuck in a common tube that drains both the pancreas as well as the gallbladder. Because the stone is stuck in the common tube, there's a sudden buildup of fluid in both of these areas. This buildup of fluid in the pancreas is what causes pain, swelling, and irritation of the pancreas, also called pancreatitis. The second most common cause of pancreatitis is alcoholic pancreatitis, in which alcohol directly damages the pancreas. I want to take 2 minutes here and discuss a bit on alcohol use disorder and its consequences or its effects, because this is a common question that a lot of patients have. How do I know if I have a drinking problem? You have a drinking problem if alcohol negatively impacts your life. So you have to ask yourself these questions. One, have you lost control over your drinking? That is, do you drink more than you intend to or more than you planned on drinking? Number two, do you need larger and larger quantities of alcohol to achieve the same effect? Or when you stop drinking, do you get physically sick, start getting tremors? Or do you get an intense craving to get alcohol at times when you have stopped it? And number three is, has alcohol caused problems in your relationship with your family members or your relationship with your friends? Or have you lost your job, or has it caused trouble at work? Or have you had trouble with law enforcement because of alcohol? If the answer to any of these questions is yes, then yes, you do have a drinking problem. So what can you do? The first step to recovery is identifying that there is a problem. Then you need to tell your doctor or your healthcare provider that, look, I'm dependent on alcohol and this is what is happening in my life. Most likely, your doctor will refer you to a qualified psychologist or psychiatrist who is trained in alcohol dependency and alcohol de-addiction. There are also many support groups available for alcohol de-addiction, the most famous of which is Alcoholics Anonymous. How much alcohol is allowed, or how much is the safe limit of alcohol consumption? Now, this is a tricky question, because if you have had health problems due to alcohol use, for example, if you have had liver disease, cirrhosis, an episode of acute pancreatitis, or heart problems or neurological problems due to alcohol use, then alcohol is a poison for you and you need to stop alcohol consumption immediately and completely. Okay, there is no safe limit for alcohol consumption for such people. Now, for everyone else who is a normal individual, the recommended safe limit for alcohol consumption is 14 units of alcohol per week, provided that you have no more than 3 units at one given time, that is during one day, and you have at least 2 alcohol-free days in the week. So what is 3 units of alcohol? It's 1.5 pints of normal beer, or 1 pint of strong beer, or 1 glass, that is 250 ml of wine, or 2 pegs, that is 60 ml of hard liquor, which includes whiskey, vodka, rum, gin, etc. Can I stop drinking on my own? A lot of people who identify that they have alcohol use disorder do stop drinking on their own. But if you are drinking every day for several weeks and this has been continuing for a few months, that is, you are a heavy drinker, it is best to stop drinking with the help of your doctor. The reason being is that the moment you stop drinking, the physical withdrawal symptoms will be very severe. So coming back to pancreatitis, these are the two main causes of pancreatitis: gallstone disease and alcohol use. In alcoholics also, it happens after a severe binge of alcohol. A moderately heavy drinker has too many drinks and 1 to 2 days later will develop severe belly pain, more often at the top of his belly, and this goes like a band around the body to the back. That is, it radiates to the back and often associated with nausea and vomiting. What test is there for pancreatitis? Your doctor, after you come to him with these symptoms of belly pain and nausea, vomiting, has to think that, okay, this can be pancreatitis, and he will ask for certain enzyme blood test levels to be done. If your blood levels of these enzymes are more than 3 times normal, then a diagnosis of pancreatitis is made. In some cases, your doctor may also ask for a CT scan in which the pancreas is seen and a diagnosis is made. How is pancreatitis treated? Pancreatitis is usually treated in the hospital. Even mild cases of pancreatitis, it's usually advisable to get hospitalized, and when you're in the hospital, your doctor will start you on IV fluids, that is saline, and also start you on IV painkillers. If you're able to eat food, that's great, but if you're not able to tolerate food, that is, if you start vomiting, then to feed you, a tube might be passed into your stomach, and this tube is usually passed through the nose to provide you additional nutrition. Now, in mild cases of pancreatitis, where the patient becomes relatively alright within 2 to 3 days, he might be discharged home after 3 days and then called for follow-up. In severe cases of pancreatitis, however, and when I say severe, I mean the patient has developed complications of pancreatitis, that is, he has developed local complications. By that I mean infection or fluid accumulation around the pancreas, or a part of the pancreas has become rotten and necrotic. Or he has developed general complications of pancreatitis, in which there is generalized infection all throughout the body and organ failure. These severe cases of pancreatitis need to be managed by a team of doctors, usually in an ICU setup, and usually in a bigger hospital. The reason being is that in severe cases of pancreatitis, your whole body is affected, your kidneys start shutting down, and so toxins are not expelled from your body. There might be fluid accumulation inside your lungs causing difficulty in breathing, and all of this needs extensive supportive management in the form of maybe ventilatory support, that is, you may need a ventilator or may need dialysis. So you need to be in a hospital that has a equipped ICU to manage these very sick patients. And a lot of the time, even in spite of best efforts, patients with severe pancreatitis sometimes do not survive and die from the illness. The second most important part of treatment for pancreatitis includes treating the cause of the disease. As I mentioned earlier, if a stone is stuck in the common tube between the pancreas and the gallbladder, this stone may need to be removed. And this procedure for removal is called endoscopic retrograde cholangiography. And I'll probably make a video on it in time. Also, the gallbladder will also need to be removed because recurrent stones will keep getting passed from the gallbladder into this common tube. And if you don't remove the gallbladder, you will again and again keep getting recurrent episodes of pancreatitis. Now, a lot of the time, your surgeon or your doctor will do this gallbladder surgery in the same admission as the pancreatitis, or some doctors would prefer to discharge you, send you home, and call you for the surgery 6 weeks later. The second cause of pancreatitis, which is alcoholic pancreatitis, requires the patient to stop alcohol completely and totally. So this is usually done with the help of a qualified psychologist or psychiatrist who may prescribe you some medicines, may counsel you, and also ask you to join a support group. This is all for the video today. I hope you liked the video and it has helped you in some way. If it has, please do remember to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.